Hey everyone, this is Oppo Reno 3 Pro and in this video I'm going to show you some of its features, some of its cool features. The first setting we will look at is in the phone manager. Here's the phone manager icon, or you can go to tools and here you will find phone manager by default. So here's the phone manager, just tap on that one and here you will see privacy permissions. Now here there is startup manager. I didn't see this startup manager on several other phones, like if they are running some different versions of Android. So here's the startup manager. What this basically does is whenever you turn on the phone, let's say you power off the device and you turn on the phone, automatically in the background there are a lot of applications that keeps running and consumes battery. So in order to avoid that, for example, as you can see, Daily Hunt. So if I turn off the mobile and turn on the mobile sometime, someday, these applications will automatically run in the background without your permission. So if you don't want to do that, just go ahead and tap this one, like switch off this one manually, which means it won't run in the background unless until you turn the app on. So this is very nice feature I felt, which is available on the Color OS version of I think pretty much all the Oppo phones here. This is the startup manager, and as usual you have other app permissions and floating windows here as well. So this is the startup manager, and here you will find all the applications that you want to run whenever the phone is turned on. If at all you have some application that you want to run in the background as soon as the phone is turned on, you can actually manually go ahead and turn on it just like this. I would suggest you turn off everything whenever you want. Obviously you launch the application and look for the news or Facebook and several other stuff. We just don't want these applications to be running in the background. Just toggle it off for all the applications right over here. So this was first feature. The second one is XHD. Now if you didn't know about this, Oppo Reno 3 Pro captures 108 megapixel of detailed sharp images. 108 megapixel picture. Of course it's software oriented, but still the images come out pretty good detail, I would say. So by default, if you just launch the camera application and here you will find 64 MP, so you can actually enable and capture 64 megapixel shots. But in order to capture 108 megapixel image, I'll just show you very quickly. So here's the mini on. Okay, now what we will do is capture picture using default mode. As you can see, this is in photo mode here right now, and I'll just go ahead, tap on this one, remove the 64 megapixel. By default, if I just go ahead and click the picture, now this will be of around 12 megapixel, as you will see, 3.6 MB size, and 4608 by 3456, which means around 12 megapixel shot this is. And what I will do is enable this 64 megapixel, then click a picture. Now you will see the resolution here. Just bump up in resolution. In details here you'll find 9216 by 6912, right? So this is of like 64 megapixel. Now if I just go ahead and click on more here, tap on Pro Expert. Now enable this XHD, okay, extra HD is turned on. Now I'll just hold it steady and click a picture. Now boom, look at the image size, generating extra HD on. Go to details here, 12,032 by 9,024 pixels. Now that's insane amount of megapixel you got here, which means 108 megapixel of image resolution. So this is the trick that you need to apply in order to capture 108 megapixel shots on this Oppo Reno 3 Pro. Alright guys, quickly moving on, we will move to call recording here. Just tap on this one and here you will find settings, right? So just go to settings here, and there are a bunch of things that you can customize over here. There is identification of unknown numbers. If you haven't turned this on, you can turn this on. Like if there are any unknown numbers, it will recognize and let you know if it's a spam or something like that. And there is also call recording option here. So you can record only specific number calls, like if you are getting from that particular number only, then you can enable call recording. You can view call recordings from here. You can also set maximum call recordings, like if you want 1000 to be the maximum number of call recordings, you can just do that. Set the limit. There are options like record specific numbers. Just go ahead here and tap on plus, and you can add the contacts that you want to be recorded. So you can manually do all these things and make sure you run the phone just the way you want. Also, there is this use power button to hang up while screen is on. Again, this is a nice trick. Like let's say the call is incoming right now, and if I just press the power button, the call gets automatically disconnected. So you can also quickly use this toggle over here. There is also auto answer here. If you just enable this one, and automatically within 5 seconds, automatically the call will be received. So you can directly talk instead of swiping up the call screen like that. Alright, that was a quick setting regarding call recording. The next one is about adding blacklist as well as whitelist, like if you want to block particular numbers. Again, we'll go to call option here, again settings, or rather block and filter. Just tap on that one, say allow, and here you'll find blocked calls, blocked messages. You can set the rules like which number you want to be in blacklist, which number you want to be in whitelist. So you can just set that. As you can see, just tap on plus. Like if I don't want this particular number to be like calling or receiving any messages from that number, you can just go ahead, select number, tap on that particular contact, and you won't receive the call or message from that particular number. So this is the way of putting that one in blacklist or in whitelist. Like whitelist, in the sense calls and messages from whitelist numbers will be blocked, but you can still see that the calls and messages were actually coming from that particular number. So that's the little trick you can apply there. And the next one is regarding screen recording. As you guys know, all the phones now support screen recording. Now here, if you just tap and hold the record screen option, here you will find the video resolution, which is very important. By default it is 720p, just change it to full HD 1080p. And there is one more thing, like you can enable the front camera, you can talk to the camera and then still be able to record the screen, which is again a nice thing. Not a lot of phones give that option. There is also record microphone sound, which means you can also talk and show the screen like what you are doing and what you are trying to say, and you can directly record the screen itself. The next one is about managing the notifications. So let's move to the settings here, and here you will see notification and status bar. Just tap on this one, manage notifications, just tap on this one. Now this is again available on all the phones, but still just showing you how to customize the notification. Let's say you are receiving unnecessary notification from this particular app, Amazon Shopping. You can just go ahead and disable this one. You won't receive any notification from this particular app. Similarly, some unnecessary apps will be always there inside the phone, so you can just toggle them off so that you don't receive any unnecessary notifications from that particular applications. So that's a little trick over there. If you apply it properly, you won't get any notification from that particular application. The next one is settings, then tap on Wi-Fi. Here if you just tap on dual channel acceleration, now this will simultaneously use mobile data as well as Wi-Fi. Like if Wi-Fi has some trouble, automatically the internet is shifted to towards the mobile data, thereby saving you, like you don't get disconnected while you are browsing or watching videos or playing games. So simultaneously internet will be running in the background so that you don't lose any important things. So this is how you enable, like you just turn on the dual channel acceleration, that time mobile data as well as Wi-Fi will be turned on. So that's again a little trick you can apply. The next one is in display and brightness. Let's go to settings, display and brightness. Here actually you can customize dark mode. Just tap on dark mode. There are two options here. One is to permanently enable dark mode, like if I just go ahead and turn this on, so permanently everything becomes dark, right? So this is typical dark mode. Like if I just go ahead and toggle this off, rather I would suggest you enable the schedule time. Let's say for example 9 PM to morning 7 AM, you can enable dark time, like 7 PM set the start time, then end tomorrow at 7 AM, and you can always turn this thing on. So that way you can actually switch to dark mode automatically. The most cool thing about this one Oppo Reno 3 Pro is with the screen off lock. Yes, they have given always on display here, which is nice thing. Of course it has been for a while, but still with the name screen off lock, if you didn't know about it, has the always on display. You can always go here, screen off clock. What this basically does is if I lock the screen, as you will see, so there is always on display here, time, date and notification, also about the battery percentage. So as you can see, I have turned this on. You can also schedule time, like when you want the screen off to be, like if you are working at some times, then you can set the screen off to quickly glance at notification and time. You can schedule time or keep it always on. There is also pure screen off, which means only time will be displayed. If I just turn this thing on, and as you will see, only time will be displayed here, as you are seeing. Now how to change those things, like clock style, here it is. I'll just show you, tap on clock style, there you go. There are a lot of customization thing here. If I just tap on this one, say enable, some cool looking themes for the clock style. So again, you can customize to your liking clock style. There are so many different options here. There is analog mode as well. So if I keep this one and lock the screen, boom, there you go. So that's the always on feature. and you can either display Gregorian calendar or display Gregorian as well as lunar calendars. There's always this green color temperature, like if you want to make it cooler or warmer as you use more mobile often and often, you can always change that to warm or cool. There's display size which gives you like way more resolution or way more content can be viewed in just one display. You can change it to small and see it for yourself how this changes. As you will see, even the icons, the screen size and everything, I'll just show you. We will take this thing back, and here you will see now, like if I go to options, all the display size is just a bit smaller than usual. So you can always keep that. Otherwise, if you have problems viewing, you can make it large as well, so that everything is easy to your eyes. So guys, in this video, this much. These were the settings. In another video, I'll show you more features. For that, hit that like button, share it with your friends, and don't forget to click on that subscribe button. I'll also show you some interesting camera settings about this mobile phone very soon. This was Oppo Reno 3 Pro, and yeah, click that subscribe button. I will see you all in another one. Till then, take care, everyone. Bye-bye.